Hello, hello, my lovely ladies. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am back with another Will I Buy It? Yes, that is right. I am going to do the Will I Buy It videos again, but I put a little spin on it. And if this is your first time here, then hi, welcome. My name is Anneke Dis, and on my channel, I want to inspire you to use a little bit of color every day by creating fun, colorful looks, but in keeping them a little bit more elegant, a little bit more wearable, so you can actually play with color every day. Color just makes me happy, man. So I want to play with color every day and I want to show you how you can do the same. I also try out a lot of new makeup, especially from high-end and indie brands. And if this sounds like your jam, if this is totally up your alley, then please consider subscribing. I upload 2 times a week and sometimes I even throw in a bonus video. If you have been following me for a little bit, you will know that I have been doing these new makeup releases, Will I Buy It videos, for a very long time. I stopped for a few months because I got a little bit sick of them. I loved them. I love to chat about new makeup and I love to chat with you about new makeup. But the thing is, it wasn't really interactive and it was really like, this is coming, I want to get it. This is coming, I don't want to get it. It's totally fine because I think it's a fun video to do it like that. And, you know, Samantha March, This video is based on the Will I Buy It series from Samantha March. So I'll help. This video is based on the series Samantha March does on her family. Yeah. This video is based on the Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. I will have her channel and the community playlist linked down below in the description box. And if you have been here before, if you have been following me for a bit, you know I used to do this like new makeup releases, Will I Buy It type of videos before. It's just that I got a little bit bored with them. So I was thinking about this and I was like, okay, I want something that is a little bit more interactive. So I love to have a channel because I want to chat about makeup with you guys. But I felt like with the way I was doing these videos before, there wasn't really a lot of interaction going on. So in order to make these videos a little bit more interactive, I've decided to put the new releases into categories and you get to decide who wins that category. So you leave me a comment down below telling me what release you think won that category. I will be doing this video every month, so we're just going to look back at January today and see what releases we think are winning those categories. Let's just start and then you will know what I mean. I am going to start with the best indie releases I saw for the month of January. The first one I want to talk about is quite new. It's a quite new announcement. It's Makeup Geek and they are releasing a new mascara. And it's called the Extension Effect Mascara. It will be available now on their website. The claims are that it's a volumizing and lengthening mascara formulated to make your lashes look like extensions without the cost or upkeep. It has a matte finish, high coverage, water resistant, 24-hour hold, and it contains castor oil and calendula extract to protect the lash as well. The mascara is going to be $12.89. That's a weird price in US dollars. They also have an eyelash curler. You can get a bundle and you can get another bundle. You have 2 bundles, one with 2 products and one with 3 products. Okay, I must say, I will put up like the before and afters. It looks, for me, it mainly looks like a lengthening and not necessarily a volumizing mascara. But I love mascara that does it all. So for me, it was like, okay, I think it is also cool that Makeup Geek is dabbling in something else than just their powder product. So I think it's nice that they are going to release a curler and a mascara. So this is something I think, yeah, this sounds intriguing. Then another one that has launched, I think this month, yeah, it's already launched, is two new palettes by Midas Cosmetics. These are the Unveiled palettes and you have one in Berry Nude and you have one in Cool Nudes. And I think both of them look really nice because I love a palette that goes quite deep, so you can make somewhat of a sultry look. You know, there's a time and place for very light eyeshadow, but I do love the option of deepening up my look, but I also want something that is very light. And I think that both of these palettes give a beautiful shade range. So I think these look really nice. They're $18 each. I didn't pick them up, but I think this is a very nice release from Midas. Then Divina Cosmetics has added two new shades to their Aurora Flare collection. I bought the first, I think, 5 or 6 of the Aurora Flares. I will do an eye swatch video, I think, soon, because I really want, I haven't touched them yet. They have been in my drawer for, I think, over a month now, and I haven't even touched them yet. I really have to. So let me know down below if you want to see like a eye swatch video, or if you want to see me doing some looks with them. Let me know down below. There will be a video. But these are two of the new Aurora Flare ones, and you have the Phenomenon and you have the Hemisphere. They look really, really pretty. They are going to be $16 each. I have no clue if they're already sold out, probably. But these look really nice. And then the last release in this Best Indie Release category is a new palette from Tammy Tanuka. And it's the Inspired Sigil brand, I think it's called. It looks so cute. Can I be a bitch? But seriously, I think this is supposed to be a cat on the front or on the inside of the palette, but it looks like a gremlin. So I'm not a cat person, but doesn't it look like a gremlin a little bit? It's okay, but the colors look so cute. The only thing though, when you hear me saying that I really love something you can deepen up, this is not a palette I can deepen up the look. So for me, it's a little bit like, it's nice, it looks really cute, but it's not like, it's a companion palette for me. This would be a companion palette. I wouldn't like a full look with only these shades. Then for the next category, that is the Helma category, I won't be getting these, but I want to bitch a bit about these. The first one are these atrocious, my God, totally redundant, way too much shadows, never buy these, from King Beauty Shop. Oh my God, what are they doing? These are 4 eyeshadow palettes. You have the Kitty, the Owl, Elephant, and the Mermaid. They are $30 each, or you can get the bundle for $50, and you only get Kitty and Owl. You can get them on Amazon. I think that says enough. You don't need these. This is so redundant. The shape of the palette makes me like, I get anxiety about these palettes. Really, the shape, they're all jumbled up. I don't get this. I really don't understand that brands are still doing this. Having way too big palettes, having redundant shades, and having them all jumbled up like that. You can't store these. And I can't, if I'm really honest, if I'm looking at these, it seems like they're all the same shades, but they just divided them over 4 different type of packaging. It's atrocious. It's a hell no. Another release, I'm like, I'm never going to get this. It's a new mask from Glam Glow. It's already available, and it's a gold one because of Marilyn Monroe. And I'm like, the only thing I've done, I think, with this is taking the Gravity Matte and the Super Matte and making them gold. That's the only thing that happened. Not even. One is gold and they have like a Marilyn Monroe signature on the lid. And the other one is just a Super Matte in the usual packaging, I think. I don't know about the Gravity Matte. Is it usually gold? Because they didn't really do anything to the Super Matte. That's always in that packaging. The only thing that changed is the signature from Marilyn Monroe on it, and they say limited edition. Why can't they just, you know, make something new? It's so boring just to repack. Who do they think they are? MAC? My God, this is so stupid. Helma. And then the last thing, and please don't kill me over this, But this is a new launch from Etude House, and they have collabed with Hershey's Chocolate. There are three palettes, and you don't need this. These are three brown palettes in a Hershey Kiss-like packaging. The thing with me and cutesy packaging is like, I'm not 12. I'm a grown-ass woman. I don't need stupid Hershey packaging. Just make a quad. It's like there's a lot of redundant space in here. There's a lot of, you know. And it's not exciting. It's not exciting. And the same thing goes for like the colors. They look very similar and they don't even go that deep. So what are you going to do with this? Seriously, what are you going to do with this? I don't get it. I seriously do not get it. You get some brushes, you get some lip stuff. Please don't. Just skip it. You don't need this. If you have like one Anastasia Beverly Hills palette, then you are done. You are totally set with your nudes. You don't need this, seriously. Then I have a category which I have called Jurious Out, because I don't know about these. They look something, but are they really? So I really want your opinion on these. The first thing is MAC Cosmetics. They have launched a new shades of their Pro Longwear Paint Pot eyeshadows. And they look kind of nice. Not all of them. Totally not all of them. But they look kind of nice. Especially, I think I am totally eyeing that purple one, that terracotta orange one, and the green one. But also that like silvery topper type of deal. It looks really nice. But on the other hand, I'm like, do I need these? You get a lot of product in here, so that is good. But wouldn't it be drying out? Is this something? Is this really something? I don't know. I think there are a lot of new shades, because you have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 new shades. $23 each day are available on Ulta. I have no idea if they are available in Europe just yet. But I'm like, is this something? Is this something? Jury's out. So let me know down below. This is something from Anastasia Beverly Hills. It's their new collection. Can I just say that because they haven't released a palette in a while, I am actually curious about a new palette from them. I can actually say, yeah, I would like to see a new palette. Is that crazy? Because, you know, we had that palette gate last year. They were like throwing up palettes at us. And now it's like crickets. And which I think is a good thing, because we were all complaining about the releases being too much, being too many. But now I'm like, I'm really wondering what Anastasia Beverly Hills is up to. So I wouldn't mind seeing a new palette. Instead, we got like, I think it's an ice collection. Is it an ice collection? What's it called? It's like ice collection, because you have the brow freeze. That is $23. You have a highlighter that is called Iced Out. That is $34. And then you have a gloss that is $20 in diamond and in crystal. So you have two shades. I think it's all about the shine and the hold. Because ice, you know, it's like very firm. That's a weird word to use. And the rest is really shiny. The only thing though, what has gotten me a little bit like, why? Is because it's a clear, you have like a clear gloss and one with a little bit of a sparkle, I believe. Then you have a highlighter that is called Iced Out, but has a very like golden undertone, as I have seen on the web. And then you have the brow freeze. I think the only thing that is slightly intriguing to me is the brow freeze, because it's a clear brow gel, but I don't like that it is in a pot like that, because it might get dirty. I don't know. For me, it was like jury's out on these. I don't know if I like this. So let me know down below. What do you think? Do you like this? Do you think it's brilliant? Do you think it's like the next coming of Jesus? Or is it a bit bullshit? Let me know down below. And then something I thought looked really cute, but I can't really make out if this is something. Well, basically, what is this? This is a Marvelous Balm from Winky Lux. And these are in three shades. They're $18 each. You have Delightful, that is called Peachy Pink. You have Dreamy, that is Natural Pink. And you have Giddy, that is Cool Toned Baby Pink. I think the packaging looks really nice. But if you look at like the color on the lips, I'm like, especially like that purpley rose one, I don't like that. Maybe the peachy one kind of looks nice. And maybe it's a smart thing because people are not really wearing lipsticks, but it's nice to wear a balm underneath your mask. So maybe this is something that is kind of smart and I'm just like, am I missing something? But also it looks intriguing because, okay, let's be frank. They mostly look yummy. They mostly look like it's nice candy. You had these like little drops of candy when I was a kid. They were like fruit with a little bit of a yogurt thing. Maybe that is what is intriguing about this. I don't know. They look cute. It's just, I'm like, is this something? Or should I just skip? Okay, then I have a category with some high-end goodness. The first one is the new Shiseido Synchro Skin Radiant Lifting Foundation. I'm wearing it today because I'm doing a wear test. I have it right here. I'm doing a full day wear test, so I think that video will be coming up after this video. So keep your eye out for that. But I'm trying this because I think it is really intriguing. It is like the Soap Refreshing, but it is in a radiant finish. So I really wanted to get this. I really wanted to try this because I thought the other one, it looked a little bit drying and cakey and it wasn't for me. So I was like, okay, you know what? I just want to try this one. I got it in the shade 2020 Linen. That is very, very good shade match for me. In the video, I will be comparing it to some other foundations and the shades I have in those. So if you're interested or if you're curious, then please ring the bell so you will know when that is coming up, because I don't know right now. It's $47. I paid €50. So in Europe, it's a little bit more expensive. And they also have a Synchro Skin Soft Blurring Primer, which is $36. I didn't get that because I'm good. So yeah, that is something I think is really nice. I'm just wearing it for the first time today, so I can't really tell you. But the first impressions is nice. So check out the video because I'm going to keep this on for like 7 hours. So you will know at the end of the day or at the end of the video if this is something you should get. Then I saw the Beautylish has released a new brush set. And these are the Yano Series Face Set. They look really nice. It's just always a little bit with Beautylish. I'm like, yeah, is this really something? It's a curated collection of makeup brushes designed to deliver the ultimate in luxury, whether you're blending, buffing, or finishing your look. Each brush is meticulously handcrafted by master artisans in Kumano, the brush making capital of Japan. Well, I want to go there. These are already available. I don't see any pricing just yet, but I think they look nice. It's just, yeah, it's just something I thought, yeah, this looks nice. It's not like mind-blowing, but it does look nice. I love brushes. This is going to be the year of a brush for me. So yeah. And then the last one I have in this category is a new collection from Chantecaille. It's the Spring 2021 collection and it just launched. The packaging, once again, is to die for. I must say, I am not really that intrigued by the eyeshadows because they look really, really light. But if you are someone that loves like that wash of color, just a simple eye look, especially in spring, then I totally get why you would go for this. The packaging though, goals. Goals, but I can't keep buying makeup for the packaging. I can't do that. The quad is $96 and the lip cheek are $64, I think each, which I think is a little bit steep for like, it's I think a bit of a balmy type of thing. You have three shades, the Peach Blossom, the Clover, and the Hyssop. I don't know. It looks really nice. It looks very pastel. It looks really springing. Typically Chantecaille, stunningness. I'm not going to get it because I think it is a little bit expensive. Then I want to talk about some collabs and influencer brands. The first one is from Juvia's Place. They have launched a new six-pan palette and they've collabed on this palette with Vanessa Chiama. Vanessa Chiama. Am I saying that right? I'm sorry if I'm butchering the name. But this is a 6-pen eyeshadow palette. It's 15 bucks. There's also a nude lip gloss. There is a Naomi lip gloss. And there's a Vanessa Collection bundle. And you can get the whole bundle for 39 bucks. I think this looks really beautiful, really stunning. I love the palette because I really love those warm tones, but I also love that there is like very light shimmer, but also very deep matte. So you can get a lot of different looks out of just a palette with 6 pens. So I think this is great and it looks really pretty. I don't think I'm going to get it because I'm not going to get anything but Juvia's Place until they come to Europe. Because I heard through the grapevine that they are going to put a warehouse in Europe as well. So that means I don't have to pay taxes. So I'm just going to hold off on that. I'm just going to wait. So I think this looks really stunning. Then something I think is really exciting. I didn't want to jump on this right away, but I probably will get it. But you can decide for me. In the next category, you get to decide what I'm going to get a review on my channel. This is Glow by Auric, and it's the new brand from Samantha Ravendel. I have been watching Samantha Ravendel forever. I love her. And I love that she launched something that is so, so on brand for her. And I have seen and heard only great things about one, the product, but also about like customer service. The launch went really well. I don't even think they sold out everything, which I love because I hate it when a new brand sells out on everything and then takes months to restock. It's just annoying. I get it. I understand it because I know it's a lot of money to launch products, but sometimes it can get a little bit annoying. It has a very luxury feel. And I know people have been complaining a little bit about the pricing, but I don't mind it because I like high-end and luxury makeup. You can get the Glow Lust for 45 bucks. It's a 35 mils packaging. I think that is quite a lot, so I don't think you will run out anytime soon. And then there are 3 Smoke Reflect Eye Duo Compacts. There's a mirror in there and you get a pressed shadow and a cream shadow. And the pressed shadow is like a glitter. I think you have one in Temper, Defiance and Ego. And I want to try Defiance and Temper. I think they look so stunning. And these are 39 bucks. And I think the 39 bucks is what people are complaining about because it's an eyeshadow. I know it's a double type of deal, but it's expensive. I get why people are a little bit like, oh, that's too bad. And then the third thing I want to talk about is, of course, the Club Nebula palette from Kaleidos and Angelica Nyquist. I am like the biggest fan of Angelica Nyquist and the biggest fan of Kaleidos. So them coming together, that is the second coming of Jesus. I'm sorry, I'm not religious, so people will totally hate me for saying this, but this for me is the second coming of makeup Jesus. It is stunning. I've ordered this palette on launch day. It is on its way to me. And if this gets here, I'm going to do a 3 looks, 1 palette. Definitely. And I'm going to do it totally Anna Kris style. I'm totally going to do it wearable, chic, elegant, a little bit different, I think, than other people will be doing it. But so keep your eye out. Just keep your eye out for that video. But I love, love, love this collab and I love that it's already on its way to me. I don't know for sure, but I think it is sold out now. So I'm really sorry if you couldn't get it. All right, then the last category is Love Me Some of These. And I have 4 things in here. And I would want to ask you to vote down below which of these products you think I should get and review on my channel. So this is like it's you and me thing, girl. It's you and me thing. The first thing is, of course, the Glow by Auric. As I said, let me know. Do you want me to get this and review it? Let me know down below. But also, something I was like, I really want to get this. It's the new collection from MAC for spring 2021. It's the Black Cherry collection. And I think this looks so stunning. And I know it's probably just new packaging on old products, but my gosh, I love the Boom Boom Bloom. And this is like its more darker and edgy sister. I love it. There are 3 lipsticks in here, 4 lip balms, 4 blushes, a fix plus setting spray in a beautiful packaging. Lashes, an eyeliner and a mascara. It's available in China and it's coming soon to other retailers. I haven't seen it here in Holland yet, but if it does drop here, I can promise you I am going to pick something up. And I think I really want to try something, some of the blushes, because I don't really have that type of blush yet from MAC. I definitely going to get the Fix Plus because I love that packaging. I want to get a lipstick. And I think that's it. I don't think I want to get a balm necessarily. I just want to get a lipstick because I just don't wear... If I know I'm going to wear a mask, I just... Either I forget that I'm going to wear a mask and I will have lipstick on and it's a whole thing. Or I just don't wear anything. Just clear gloss because just... Yeah. So yeah. So I probably will get a lipstick. But you will have to let me know down below if you think I should get this or no. Then the third thing that... totally got my eye is the new collection from NARS. They have a face palette or a face duo and they have an eyeshadow palette. The eyeshadow palette is $49 and the face duo I think is the same price. I don't really see another pricing here. It has already launched on the 27th, so it's already here. And it looks really, really nice. It looks really nice. I am someone that loves an eyeshadow palette that has more mattes than shimmers. But in this case, somehow these pink tones and then that like goldy tones and taupey tones, they're getting to me. The face duo looks really nice as well because I don't think there's any Orgasm and Laguna in here. If there is, I'm totally going to skip it, but it doesn't look like it. I am eyeing this eyeshadow palette big time. Big time. Let me know down below, should I get it or should I not? And then the last thing... I'm like, okay, I think I want to get this. Basically for the same reasons I think the NARS palette looks really nice. And it's a new release from Violet Voss. They have launched their All of You Forever. All of You Forever, so... Is it corny or is it cute? I think it's a little bit corny. All of You Forever palette. And it is $34. It is... They say olive, but if I look at the swatches... There's only one green shade in here. So I'm a little like, is it really olive though? But I do love the rest because it's really grungy. And it's really like, it goes from light to dark. So it's really something I would love, you know? And I think it looks really nice because it's really murky. I think it looks really nice in the palette. But if I look at the swatches, it's like, I don't know. But I think it intrigued me. So let me know down below, do you think I should get this? Or any of these four. Let me know down below. First of all, do you like these type of videos? Do you like me to put it in categories? And you and I just chatting about what we think of these releases. And do you think I should do this live? Or in a premiere style thing so we can really talk about it? I would love to know. Also, let me know. I will have in the description box all the releases that I talked about per category. So you can vote on which release you think fits that category the most. I love to hear from you. Let me know down below, babes. I love to chat new makeup. Okay, ladies, thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up if you think that this is a fun way to do this. Will I buy it? Subscribe if you haven't already because I would love to see you in my next one. Bye.